went through many precepts in the last couple of classes. And now I want to give a short example how it works. We're not done with the precepts, but I want to summarize some of the last classes with an example that the book says, not that I invented. Last few classes ago, I gave you my own experience how the Lashon Hara can come in a very day-to-day base. Here is giving an example that we can see how the precepts unfold in a certain situation. So it says as follows, Veda, you should know, the ones who are go and speak a lot of gossiping, matsui meod love, there's another love, another precept that is very common, al yedei ma shekorim lo be'ashkenaz, in the Ashkenaz way of saying, oisfiren. Now, I don't know Ashkenaz, so I don't know what it means. Maybe you know. But he will say, I'll explain to you what it means. Asbir lecha ze belashon ha-kodesh. I will explain to you that in the holy language. Kedei lida kama lavim doraita baim al yedei midah groa zo. Let me explain to you how many lavim, how many precepts from the Torah will come by having this bad midah. And it goes like this. Kshesaper Reuven l'Shimon, he's giving names, okay? So Reuven comes to Shimon and he tells him, Levi diber alecha. Now we're going to go with names, so just focus on the names, okay? So Reuven comes to Shimon and tells to Shimon, Levi spoke about you like this and like that. Now Shimon is already... smoke is coming out of the ears. What? That's what he said about me? Right away, so now Reuven failed with the love, lo tilech achil be'amecha, and this is the first love that we learned, and in English, it means you should not go around as a gossip monger amongst your people. First love that Reuven failed, right? Ushar lavin v'asiyin, and not only that, all the rest of the loving that we learned in the last couple of classes, because it's all the same idea of the Lashon Hara. Now there's a second problem. Shimon ma'amin ledvarav. Shimon accepts the Lashon Hara and believes every word. Instead of saying, listen, I know Levi, he wouldn't say that, let me check. He right away believes the word that Shimon told him. What does he do? Uover belav delo tisa shem hashav. Now, Levi now, Shimon, is in a problem of the precept, you should not accept a false report. How do you know if it's true? Not Mr. Shimon. Right? Right away, you flipping over on Levi, because Reuven told you something? Well, I say, well, okay, thank you, I will check. So now Shimon is in a problem, because of Reuven, by the way. Ve'achar kach, now what happens is, כשפוגע Shimon בלוי, הוא מתחיל לחרפו. Now Shimon sees Levi in the street and starts screaming at him. Yo, 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 come here. What are you talking about like this? Oh, Levi's like, what are you, whoa, relax. So he starts screaming at him. And he's so upset, Shimon, that he's starting to insult him. Now once he's screaming at him and insulting him, he's now transgressing a different love. Lo tonu ishet amito. This is another love that we learned about. And the translation is, you should not wrong one man. Okay? Why are you attacking me, Mr. Shimon? What did you really think that's what I said? Why? Dechi mishum shu mekabel lashon hara alav v'choshev shu diber alav lashon hara utar lo lenot oto. Shimon accepted lashon hara from Reuven. Now he goes to Levi and starts screaming at Levi. And wait a minute, why are you accusing me? I didn't say anything. So you accepted the Lashon Hara, now you're going against Levi. Now look how Reuven put Shimon in a bad situation. Are you following the names? Okay. Now Levi omed u'mishta'e. Levi's like, what are you talking about? I never said such a thing. Why are you losing your temper in me? Why are you cursing me? Why are you insulting me now in front of everybody? Alma ve'lama atam charfeni. What are you doing? What do you want from me? Ad sheShimon bechaso mesaper lo. Now Shimon tells him, Shimon is already furious. And he tells him, למה גינית אותי לפני ראובן? Why did you go and bad mouth me instead of in front of ראובן? וכי סבור אתה שאני יודע? And Shimon says, what do you think I didn't hear? What do you think ראובן didn't come and tell me? והלא ראובן סיפר לי, ראובן told me what you said. Now, when he says such a thing, he's transgressing another love. What is that? לא תלך אכיל בעמך. Now, Shimon is talking לשון הרע about ראובן. ראובן told me. Do you understand now the ping pong? As it says, בכל הפסוקים דקה לאמת. Now, we talked about לשון הרע is the truth. ראובן really did tell him. Reuven could have been just slandering Levi. But now Shimon is talking Lashon Hara about Reuven because it's true. Doesn't matter right now what was going on there. So now Shimon is in the swamp because of Reuven. Now he's talking Lashon Hara about Reuven. והוא מתרץ את דבריו לומר, now he comes and he starts defending himself. כי שקר ענה בי Reuven לפניך וחינם חרפתני. Now Levi comes and says, I'm sorry to tell you, Reuven lied to you. I never said such a thing. So now you are insulting me, you are attacking me, you're cursing me for no reason. But you believe Reuven? He's a liar! He's a pathological liar. So now Levi is talking bad about Reuven. Look at this, this is a simple discussion. Then he tells him, ואחר כך שפוגע שימון ברובן, now Shimon goes back to Reuven. היצר מסיתו לגמור עוד העניין הרע בכי טוב. Now Shimon is going back to Reuven. Well, you lied to me. Why are you telling me that? Now you know what I did to Levi? I insulted him in front of everybody. Why did you lie to me? ואומר לו, and he answers him, מפני שקרנותך הוסטתי לבלה את לוי חינם. Because you lied to me, Shimon tells Reuven, because you lied to me, now I insulted Levi and I embarrassed him. והלא הוא אומר לו, לא היו דברים מעולם. And Levi said that you are lying, that never something like this never happened. Now, as we know, our sages say, avera goreret avera, a sin will pull after it another sin, that's how it works. Now Reuven tells Shimon, now this discussion is not over. לך עמי ותראה שאני אומר את הדברים האלה בפניו ממש. Oh yeah? Let's go together to Levi. So now Reuven and Levi are going, Reuven and Shimon are going together to Levi. And Reuven says, he called me a liar? Let's go back. Let's go to him. And as I said that numerous times in the last couple of weeks, if a person wants to go on the wrong path, they assist him. Now Shimon and Reuven are going to Levi. Now Reuven is furious. Now he got him in trouble. Shimon is furious. Everybody's furious. And they go to Levi. Shimon Reuven. Now, both coming, Shimon and Reuven to Levi, and he says in front of him, inside of Levi, ומלביש עצמו במידת העזות לאמור, now Reuven comes with anger, with chutzpah, with azut, with this freshness, אתה דיברת עליו לפני כך וכך, you spoke to him about me like this and like that. Now again, what happens here? They're both transgressing, לא תלך אכיל בעמך. Now they're all both talking about each other. Even if it's all truth. ותכף מתלבן פלי לוי. Now what happens is that Reuven is insulting Levi. So now Levi is insulted. This is called Albin פני חברו ברבים. You to insult him. ועובר Reuven גם כן עליו. Now Reuven is transgressing another love. לא תישא עליו חץ. Don't put throne on that person a sin. ולוי משיב. Now you think Levi is a friar? Levi now answers back. אמת דיברתי. I said truth. אבל לא באופן זה וניגון זה אמרתי. You're right, Reuven. Calm down. You're right, I said that. But not how you said that. I said it in a completely different way. כידוע כי כמה דברים משתנים בתנועה אחת. As you know, I can say something. You can interpret it a whole different way. And then you go into Reuven, goes to Shimon and says, but he said like that. But I didn't mean it like that. ושימון משיב. Now Shimon, who's now the sandwich in between, now he answers. אתה... אף אם תכחיש אלף פעמים, לא אמין לך אחרי הדברים שאמרת בבינך. Now, even if you deny it, you lost my trust. I will never believe you. Now, if this is the case, so he's transgressing, Shimon, עוד לב, another precept, לא תישא שם השב. Don't accept a false witness, a false testimony. כמו שאברר לקמן, as we're going to explain later on, The min Torah asur la'min b'shum ofen, because the Torah doesn't tell you that you have to believe everything that you say, that you hear. The Torah says, don't jump to conclusion before you listen. V'chi mipnei sha'arasha hazeh, הלביש עצמו מידת החוצפה. Now, because Reuven dressed himself with such chutzpah, ועזות, and going in a disgusting way to tell him in front of him, הותר לב, now he's adding another transgressing, לא תישא שם השב. Now he's accepting a false testimony. הנך, הנך רואה שכמה מעליו ימנל באו מצד אהבת המידה הגרועה. Now you see how many transgressions, how many precepts were applied because of one person that has a little bit of a not refined midah characteristic and trying to stir now a whole thing from one little action. Look how everybody is now suffering with how many precepts they're failing to. She'ilu haya Reuven ze olech bedarkei Hashem. If Reuven was a yirei shamayim and would go in the path of Hashem, he wouldn't say anything. Even if he heard something from Levi, what was Levi's answer? I said it, but not how you saying it. I didn't mean it so bad. So if Reuven was a God-fearing individual, he wouldn't say anything. He wouldn't even go to Shimon and tell him what he heard. And he would accept on himself chashado shel Shimon. He would accept that maybe Shimon will suspect him. Leshakran b'inyan Levi, that he might come as a liar. ולא ללך עם שמעון אצל לוי. Now what happens is that Shimon went with him to Levi, and now the whole geshrei started. ולא סיף הבנות. Now the fact that Reuven went to Shimon, Shimon got upset, went to Levi, now they're just throwing more gasoline into the fire. ולא סיף הבנות על הבנו הראשון דרחילות. It all started from one wrong word, and look how like a merry-go-round, it's like a blender, started grabbing everybody. And this is an example with only Reuven, Shimon, and Levi. Usually it will include a few more people. Hashem yishmerenu mimidah gruah zot. Hashem should save us from this horrible character trait that I heard something and I had to come and right away report what I heard. Reuven could have shut his mouth and nothing would happen. And if he feels that Levi was supposed to be warned or Shimon was supposed to be warned, you do it in the right way. Now here is giving a very basic example. You need to use your own imagination or to see how somebody pulls you in. I mean, who was the first wrong one? It was Reuven, of course. Shimon should have been smart and say, I don't want to hear. I really don't want to hear. And if you're already saying something, okay, I will. I don't accept what you're saying. Let me go and ask Levi. And I'll add on this example that I don't remember how long it was, but when we were negotiating and working on the deal to purchase this building, then of course there were a few fairies here in this little town. They weren't so happy with my existence. Let's put it this way. So they're in any possible way did whatever they could to sabotage anything that I did. So somehow they found the owner of the building. And I don't even know what the hell they told him. But he was a smart man and he calls me. And he tells me, somebody told me something that I'm not so happy about. I just want to know if it's true or not. And he tells me, is it true? A, B, C? I says, 100% a lie. He answers, thank you, and hangs up the phone. I call him back and I tell him, ding, 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 you just won the $1 million jackpot. The fact that you didn't right away go against me, you said, okay, let me ask. You called me, I said it's a lie. Thank you so much, hung up the phone. That's how it has to be. And I told him, if you have any other questions, ask me. I will, if I need to prove or back up anything that they said, I'll prove. But this is an observant man, an individual that has his head screwed very well on his shoulders. He heard some horrible things. He says, okay, let me check. Let me do my own check. I don't even know who you are. And I know Alon very good. I don't believe what you're saying. Let me check. And all it took is a 2-second phone call. He asked, I said, 100% a lie. I told him, Sheker ve'kazav, toda rabah. Thank you. Hung up the phone. And the deal continued like as if nothing happened. Now, can you imagine the test on my side? The temptation of telling him, who told you that? So that was my test. Who told you such a thing? But of course, I had to be putting the suit of anger. Relax. Relax. You don't need to know who said that. Don't worry. So, but just I'm just sharing with you privately. Can you imagine the urge, the desire, the push to find out who told him that? But that's how things need to be held. Yes, sometimes things come across, all sorts of warnings, we'll call it. Okay, you know, to accept it, that's one of the precepts. You're not allowed to accept a false report till you prove. Maybe it's false, maybe it's not. And you go quietly and you ask. And you, if you, in this example, you are a Shimon, you go to Levi. He says, listen, I'm not looking to any arguments right now, but I heard this and that. I just need to know what's your stand, what do you think, in a nice, calm way. And if you think that Levi will not accept these accusations, then it has to come like that, that you're not going to pull him into that. The bottom line is that you have to be very calculated for every piece of information that comes in your direction, because you don't know on what landmine you're going to step. You have to be very, very calculated. So this is one example out of many. We're going to continue after that with more precepts. Then we're going to the next section up until now. And we're going to summarize it, because I know it's a little bit hard to remember it all. But we're going to finalize all the precepts. Then we're going to go to the positive mitzvot. There's a lot of positive mitzvot that can be transgressed while you gossip, slander, and say Lashon Hara and many more. But that we'll do then. In the meantime, I will give you as much as examples as we can, so you kind of focus, and when the danger is coming, you know how to stop it before it becomes a snowball. And that's really the problem, when it comes a snowball. And you tell him, and him tell him, and then it starts passing around, and then lies are starting to fly to different directions. And like we talked before, then the curses start flying, anger, and Hashem Erachem where he takes you. And now you have half the city in this whole big chunt pot. Everybody's talking against each other in one big mess. Hold your tongue from evil and your lips from saying any type of lying. Person who guards his mouth and his tongue, you guard yourself from any type of problems. You sleep better, you feel better, you digest your food better. No worries, no anger, no distractions in your mind. And you have to be very careful with how the attack is coming, from which direction.